Morning. It's 9:45. I've been awake, I don't know, about 15 minutes, so I'm just sort of going to sit at the PC for a bit and let myself wake up. And then I'm going to go and get my money out, go pay the rent, and then go around town, basically. Might have a visit to a couple of charity shops. Gonna go to my favourite junk shop as well. And this thing is very close to dropping off at last. It's been driving me up the friggin' wall, because every time I look down like that, I don't see a little thing. It does, it just gets on your wick after a while, but it is a bit sore, and I've noticed the end of it, this little skin tag, if you're wondering what it is, has split, and the skin feels dead. That, when I was looking in the mirror, it did actually look like it's close to dropping off by itself, but if I can find something sharp enough, I might help it along, because apparently that's what they do if you went to see your doctor. They just doink, snip them off. I mean, of all places, I've actually got them under my arm. I don't know if you've seen there, but there they don't bother me. This one bothers me because it gets in my line of vision. Anyway, once I've been round town, I'm going to finish this off. And it looks like I've got a little spider somewhere, because there was a hell of a lot of cobwebs over that this morning. And there's even some going from the bike to the chair as well. So I've got a little eight-legged friend hiding on there somewhere. Need to piss off, keep making webs like that. Right. Yes, I hope to get that finished. If I get it finished by this evening, then I might, and it's still like this, I may go for my little jaunt this evening, but I will let you know further in the video. I suppose I better make sure Boss has got some food down as well. I'll just check that paint. Okay, we're bone dry. Oh, I've missed a bit. Might just go over and redo some parts that I missed. I'm a bit of a dick, you know what I forgot to do, don't you? I forgot to bloody rub it down, so I've now got a rough paint finish. Oh well, shit happens. Oops. I suppose I could sand it over and redo it if I really want. I don't know if I've got any sandpaper. That would be the better job. I ain't got an angle grinder or anything. Anywho, I'm going to let myself wake up for about another 10 minutes or so and throw my pants on, throw my boots on, and bugger off. So, if I find any goodies while I'm in the junk shop, you will know about it when I come back. See you later. Right, I'm back from town. I do have quite a haul. I've got myself a 6Y. £2. Yep, £2 from the Brake charity shop. All been electrically tested as well. That's all I got from there. Well, I've also got this big bag of goodies as well. So before I get down to eating, from the Catali shop I got some brand new reflectors, 50p each. I know exactly where at least the brackets are going to go. Two more of these. Because with all the computers and things I've got kicking around, I can't have too many of these kettle leads, as we call it. They were also 50p each. I then got a wind-up torch, just for the heck of it, for a pound. Another torch for 50p, and there is another one floating around in here somewhere. There it is. A little Pifco one, 50p. Okay, so I'm going to chuck these on the floor before I run out of space. So, sort that out later. Now, from my favourite junk shop, I did get some treasures. Look at this. A Mega Drive game. A Master System game. And oddly enough, I had this one when... my brother had this one when he had the Master System when we were little boys. And I did used to play that one. Then I got a pair of cordless phones, because I'm fed up with the other one. I can't move around the flat. There is another base, but she couldn't find it. So she's going to message me when she finds the other base. Got two adapters here. I weren't sure if they both went to the phones or not, so I just grabbed them both. Cassettes. One tape for a thingy, a doodah, hoojima flip, camera, that's the one. I'm just checking that the tape is there. Yep, the tape is not broken. It's a Maxell, 8mm MP. GX Metal 90 minute tape. I think that one's going to be a little big for my little Panasonics. Actually, no, I know it is going to be. But I do have cameras I can use that on. Ah! Here's the other adapter and one of the bases. It's a Tesco set, apparently. New Hits 98, my favourite decade for music. And, I've got an audio tape. The audio tapes were 10p each, including the one for the VHS cameras. And I got a bunch of PS2 games, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in total, 30p each. And if I remember correctly, my total bill was £5.20 for this lot. So, yeah, can't complain. I do like going into that shop, because it's one of those shops where you've got to literally dig in, because there's just boxes of things outside, and, you know, and there's lots of things. I mean, it's no good going in there and having a quick browse, because you will miss something, because I nearly missed this one. And I actually didn't realise what this was until I opened it up, because there's no Sega label or anything on it. It wasn't until I opened it up and found that in there. I was like, ah, I will have that as well. I didn't even check if Super Tennis was in there. This is. So they can go and be tested later. I've got plenty of audio tapes. I don't even know what I've got, but I'll just quickly run through them. We've got the cartoons. Greatest Stars on 45, which was also a song. Queen Live at Wembley. That tape's a bit twisted though, I don't know if that's going to be... And considering I actually am going to be using tapes, I figured I'd get the head cleaner that was there. What we've got here, bit of Cher, Shania Twain, the Cheeky Girls. I can't believe they're still actually producing cassettes back then. Whitney Houston. I Want to Dance with Somebody. Lonely Talking Again. Oh, Just the Lonely Talking Again. Love Will Save the Day. Didn't We Almost Have It All? And that's on side one. Oh, it is actually an album. Now, that's what I call music volume 25. Back when I did them both on CDs and tape. What the heck is this one? I don't know. Oh, Parallel Lines. I think I should have got the rest. What we've got here? We've got Tina Turner. Looks like it's one that someone's recorded themselves. And The Eagles. So, chuck them at one side. As for the PS2 games, Metal Gear Solid 3, Snake Eater. I've never played any of these games. And Metal Gear Solid 2, Sons of Liberty. I've never played either one. Terminator, Dawn of Fate. Final Fantasy X-2. One of my friends is an absolute huge Final Fantasy fan. I do believe he's played and completed all of them. Soul Calibur 3. Project Snowblind. And probably one of these cheapy ones as well. Mashed. Drive to Survive. Ooh. I think I may have actually played this one. Don't know what the condition of the discs is like, I didn't look. A bit scratched, should play though. Or maybe not, because that's a copy disc. I didn't think to look, did I? That one's a bit mucky, but might clean up, I think, the rest. Genuine discs. Right. On that note, I'm going to pour myself a cola, put a YouTube video on, and eat lunch. Can't call it breakfast because it's 11:45. So I'll talk to you all later this afternoon. Right. So I've tested the Sega games and they both work. Well, the Mega Drive after a fashion when I gave it several blows and a good clout. But it works. I don't think I could play the sports games that often, so I'm not too worried. But I've just seen someone post a news clipping from the North Norfolk News today of the hand car wash just up the road from me, where the council want to close it because of over 100 complaints from two people regarding noise of a vacuum cleaner, even though it's in a soundproofed box. So where the noise is coming from is their own fucking imagination, basically. And the fact that the car wash is ran by non-British people. It's ran by, I haven't even got a clue how you pronounce their names, but I believe they're Polish. Ermel Sinaj, I presume that's how you pronounce his name. I haven't got a clue. Podianu Cyprian? Yeah, there's about four of them. So to me, it's just they're racist bigots. That's the only reason they're complaining, because they don't want them working there. That's it. I do a bloody good job. There's a petition going and there's over 800 signatures. The EDP ran a poll themselves and got well over 1,000 people in support of it. And to be honest, I don't know what the council are thinking, because the drainage issue that was initially brought up was fixed. Anglian Water have no problems with the drainage. Oh, I can't remember, well, what was the complaint? It's the drainage, the noise of a vacuum cleaner. I'm just reading it. Noise, nuisance and drainage. Well, the drainage isn't going to affect the houses, so I don't see how that is even a legit thing for the neighbouring two properties. Actually, there's more than one property that backs onto it. So I don't see how drainage is even an issue for them to complain about. The vacuum cleaner, as I said, is in a, they decided to put it in a soundproofed box, so really that's not an issue either. And the nuisance, what nuisance? There's a fucking garage next door. It's actually in the grounds of the garage. They rent a little plot of land from the landowner to run their little car wash on. But there's a fucking car garage, you know. There's lots of nuisance noise that's going to come from that. Hammers banging. Fucking air tools. Music, probably. And all they're worried about, well, the only nuisance they're worried about is a bit of water splashing and a fucking vacuum cleaner. Really? Fuck off, you racist cunts. Forgive my language, but that does piss me off. Because they're complaining for absolutely no reason. And I can't believe that our council are backing the complaints. Whoops, if I went a bit funny, that's because I had my thumb over the microphone. So I'll repeat that. I can't believe the council are backing up the complaints and wanting them to close. There is no reason to close them. And they're probably on the group it's been posted on, but I bet they haven't got the balls to admit it. La-da-da-da. La-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba. I just wanted to get that off my chest. Well, like I said, good news is the Sega games work. The tennis one works straight off, not an issue. My torches work, the wind-up one, I think I'd have to wind it up like hell for a few minutes to get the battery to stay charged, but where did I put that bloody little one? My little Pifco one, I put a couple of AA batteries in and that works. But as for the other one, bear with me a second. This one has batteries, but does near work. So there's going to be one of two issues with this one. Or it could be both. Could be dead batteries. So I will stick my meter across. Did that come out here? Ah, it could be the batteries, there's a little bit of leakage there. I'll just try and lighten that. Or it could be, from the look of it, possibly, I may have cranked down on that too hard and squished the end of the bulb, but actually having looked at it now, I can't fucking speak. I think it's just a case of deceased batteries. I wonder if I can just pull that spring out of there. In theory, if I can get this tab off at the top here, I should just be able just to go boink and pull it off. Clean the spring up, or at least trim that bit off where it's got or been leaked over. Like that. And it's so simply made that it's just like that. It's literally held in with this little clip at the top. Well, it's not that bad. I keep forgetting I've got to go the opposite way. That'll clean up. Bit of steel wool, and I'll pop that back in there and you're supposed to twist this to turn it on and off. I guess the idea is when you screw this down, it touches on the end of the battery, touches on this and the metal terminal bit here touches on the metal disc in there. Simple as anything. I remember, I think Roy's used to sell these epoxy things. So, I'm not even going to bother sticking my meter on them, because you can see it ain't going to work. It's leaked. I think it's leaked, anyway. Looking at there's a bit of steel wool. I'm going to try and clean that up now. I did have a bit last night, because I was cleaning bits up for the rally. Oh well, I'm going to go off and do that. Mum's got dental appointment today, so I'm presuming I'll see her at some point. Look at that. It's not even soldered on, it's just sat there. It's just twisted over it. How cheap can you get? Right. I'll, oh, here's the other torch. Back in the days, this was your pocket torch. Take the sticker off that, actually. Pifco, high energy.
Really?
I hadn't noticed. Back later. Right. Got the wheel out, it's all cleaned up. I've just got to get that stupid washer off the axle. And I'm going to change the wheel nuts. And that wheel can go back in. I've been in a town for a little while with Mum. She's just gone off to the dentist. I've got a few shopping bits while I was out there. I've got to go and get the electricery later. I've got a couple of Lego sets while we were in Sainsbury's. Reduced to clear, £10. So I grabbed that. I'm not usually into superheroes, but I actually feel like being different. I'm getting a bit bored with City at the minute. I think there's only like one or two Lego City sets I want to get now anyway, so. And I've got that one, so I'll build those up later. First, I want to get that done. So, like I said, I'm going to stop and have a bite to eat. Pardon me. Right. That's the chicken kebabs I bought on a wrong offer. Where's the bloody other one gone? Ah, slid down. Chicken drumsticks. Move all those PlayStation 2 games into their rightful spot. I'm actually wondering if I should use that chair as the gaming chair over there, because I don't need it to be high. It doesn't matter if it sits low, so... Anyway, just a quick update. I'm going to carry on. We've got a pot of wheel nuts there. I'm going to find a couple of clean wheel nuts. I don't think I'll get to go on said ride today, because by the time I've done what I wanted to do to that bike, and that's if the bottom bracket's not going to be a pain as well, so I may need new parts for that. Yeah, may end up being either tomorrow or Saturday, but I'm going to go on that ride. Oh, dear me. Done the wheel bearings, they were a little bit loose. I will need air in the tyres when I'm done. So I can get that washer off, get the back wheel back in. I'll take the front wheel out, clean that and put that back in. Change wheel nuts while I'm at it. Yeah. Jobs are good'un. Or will be. Oh, I forgot to say I bought this as well. Oh. Brand new, I couldn't resist, it's a Mustang, a GT500, and it's one that I don't have, so it's one of the few diecasts I do continue to collect. Anyway, I'll talk to you all later. Right, I think I got the mechanics side of it done. Wheels cleaned, bottom bracket bearings tightened up fine. Brakes are back together. There's a very, very minor buckle in the back wheel, which is just causing that to rub just a smidge on the left side, but it's fine. I think I've got the brakes adjusted as best I can. I'm going to take it downstairs, pump the tyres up, oil the chain. I'll give it a clean down there because my spray's down there. And we'll go from there. Let me see if I like it. If I don't like it, I'll sell it. Simple. So I was going to throw on some mud guards and whatnot, which would be good for off-roading. I've got plenty of them. My guards, some lights, if I chose to keep it. It's actually tidied up pretty well, to be honest. It's working pretty well. Front one feels a bit, probably could do with a new cable, but that'll do for the time being. It'll do. So yeah, that's what I'm now gonna do. I may actually let the air out of that front wheel just so I can realign the valve to get the pump on it. And if you look, it's at an angle. And that actually, one, to me it looks stupid, and it just drives me up the wall. It's one of those pet peeves. Right, I'm gonna clean up and get rid of that thing out of my way. It all fell over randomly. I think I may have knocked into the frame, which knocked it all over. Yeah, I believe I got cloths down there to oil this. The saddle. Actually, I've got a saddle up here. I just remembered. Got another one of these Apollo ones, and they're quite comfortable. So I'm going to stick that one up for now, before I go down. Is it an Apollo? Yeah, it is an Apollo. An Apollo seat on a rally bike. Blasphemy. Oh well. It's better than one of them Cell Royale. That thing looked like it's going to go straight up my fucking ass crack and get stuck. And it is a bit cracked as well. Oh well, right, so hopefully when I turn the camera back on, I'll be back up here with this all cleaned down and hopefully with a decision made, so I'll see you later. Right, well, I'm just sitting here at my Lego bench. I've just done a review of this set. So that's a video for the Lego channel, possibly tonight or tomorrow, whenever I can be bothered to put it up. So as you can probably tell, as I'm sitting at the Lego bench, the bike isn't up here. That I left downstairs deliberately because I oiled the chain, and I know for a fact that chain is going to drip off the oil. Shall I try that again? Oil is going to drip off of the chain. Excess oil, so I decided to lock it up downstairs for the night, so any excess oil is not going to drip all over my carpet. I don't mind dust and crap, that can all be hoovered up, but oil is a little different. And I'm going to change the chain anyway, because it rides nice, the gears shift, brakes aren't the sharpest, but for some reason it's been rare that I've come across a bike with cantilever brakes that actually have good sharp brakes. And I can see my brother messaging me from here, so where's my lever? Wrong side, that's why I can't find it. Hang on. Drop this down a bit. We'll roll over here. Oh, my cordless phones I got work. She charged me £2.50 for them, and she does have, she said somewhere, she does have the base for the other phone, but I'm not too bothered. I don't need both phones, so I could actually keep this one for a spare, which is probably what I'll do. Don't even know if this handset works. I haven't tried it yet. Oh, that's alright then. My brother just wants me to bring his PC over tomorrow. I don't know if the processor I've got in it is going to work. So I may actually find out some processors. I know for a fact I've got a dual core sitting somewhere that should go in it. He's going to sell me the 8GB set. For £20, and he wants to know if I'm going to be using the water cooler. The answer to that is no, so we're not going to remember what I've done with all the things. It's because I've lost them. I was going to put it on eBay if I found the fixings, but I'd probably only get something like £5 for it anyway, so I'm not too worried about that. He can have it, because I owe him some cash anyway, so I've actually spent out, but if he doesn't mind waiting till I next get paid, because I know £40 a fortnight doesn't seem like much, but when you put it in a context, next week I've only got my service charge to pay, which is £60. So I'll have, if I take the electric off as well, I'll have at least £160 for groceries and whatever else I need and or want. Which has actually made me happy, because that means I've got a bit of extra cash there to actually get a few more Lego City sets that I want. Because I've got to order them from Lego, because I can't get them in the shops here. Because the two stores that do them in town, because, well, they seem big for our town, but they're not really that big, so they're limited on space. So the selection is quite limited. Sainsbury's actually has the better selection. I'm surprised Roy's doesn't. But, I've got to show you this. I know this isn't a Lego channel, but I've got to show you this. Look at this. This is what you can do with Lego nowadays. You've got these, which they call stud shooters. Boing! But this one's also got rockets. Look at this. If I turn this wheel at the back here, I can shoot Batman. Boing! I love it. It's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. I haven't actually watched the Green Lantern movie. But, some people, well, I saw some reviews and people said it was crap, but I'm still going to watch it one day, you know, make my own decision. But I presume that thing in the case where my thumb is, well, that thing is meant to be the Green Lantern. I don't know. It just looks like a lantern to me and it's green, so is that what they've got to rescue? Or go and retrieve? I don't know. Like I said, I've not seen the movie. I do have another one, which I'm going to do later. I don't know if I'm hungry or not yet. I don't know why Nemo is saying feed me, because he's fed. I've got this one. Now, I'll actually be honest, again, this was on offer. And if there's one thing I've learned, is to, if you see an opportunity and you can take advantage of that opportunity, then go for it. So I went for it. Because, like, well, you know, you already know my hobby is Lego and Lego City mostly, hence, you know, why I'm building a town with cars and houses and shops and beach and whatnot. I just thought I'd be different. It's nice to have a few different things in the collection. So I've got this one. I actually really bought it because I like the Jeep. I want the Jeep in my town. I just thought that plane thing would be interesting to build as well. That's got one of these rocket launchers on. That's got Fars black ones. Yay! Right, so I'm going to sit up here actually, because I want footage to sort when I put this up to the PC. Anyway, I'm actually debating what to have for dinner. I don't know. I can cook something. I actually really could eat ham, chips and beans again. Because that was actually quite nice last night. Food in his dish. Eat that. It's just because he can see that little bit of grey in the bottom of his dish. Look, that's what it is. He's thinking, and he's trying to tell me, Daddy, I can see the bottom of my dish, I want some more food. Well, Daddy's telling you to piss off and eat what you got there. Right, so I've got chips, I've got ham. I just don't have the baked beans. Got an egg. I think I might go to Lidl's and just grab a tin of beans. Half a dozen eggs, maybe, or maybe a dozen. I think a dozen. No, it's 15 eggs, sorry, not a dozen. I think they're only like 99p in Lidl. Yeah, and I'll get some grub on. Do I get the bike out of the shed or do I actually go for a walk? I don't know, because I've got to put the BMX in the shed anyway. I've still got someone's BMX to fix. It's a kid's BMX. I thought it had 20-inch wheels in it, but it don't. They're 16s, and I think they're 16s. It might be a little bit bigger. They might be 18s, actually. Yeah, they're not quite small enough to be 16s. I'm like a plum. I got rid of that little girl's bike I had kicking around, which had 18-inch tyres on and good tubes. So I'm sort of kicking myself now. I could have done with them. I knew I should have rescued the tubes at least. Oh well, if I've got to fix a puncture, then I'll just have to fix the puncture, that's all. Anyway, I'm going to talk to you all later. I'm hungry. Well, that's the second Lego video done. Nice little Jeep. Oh dear, I've got a bit of heartburn now. Yeah, so that's why I'm sitting at my Lego bench again. Because if I don't do these videos when I think of them, I'll forget. I I'm not going to Mum's tomorrow because they can't afford to drop Mum off, pick her up from work, and me when they pick Mum up from work, and then come back again to drop me home. That's a lot of petrol, so I'm going to put it off till Sunday. That's not a problem. I'll just try and keep £10 back for the recycle centre. In the vain hope I might find at least one bike there I can do something with. You never know unless you look. Hearing a lot of movement outside tonight. Look at this. No, actually I'm not going to show you because you can't see anyway. The lad has just come cycling across the car park and whatnot out there. And it's pitch black and he's got no lights and he's wearing dark clothes as well. So what a 24 carat pillock. Like I said before, when I've mentioned bike lights, there is no reason not to have them. I mean, you don't even need friggin' tools these days to put them on. And why won't my chair go down? Is it because I'm not sat on it right? Yeah. Whee! I think I might have gone down a bit too low. I don't know. Did I? A little bit. There we go. I was playing with this and I sat winding it up for about a good two and a half minutes. And it doesn't matter how long I actually sit and wind it for, that battery just does not hold charge. So I've got a choice. For a pound, I could just take this apart for the LEDs and the motor, etc. Or I could take it apart and put another battery in it and actually use it. Because from what I can see, it's only held together with three screws on the bottom here. Two at the front there. One at the back. So I don't know. Did I take this evening's pill? Yes, because the tray is empty. I dropped my prescription in this morning, so I should get some more, because I've actually only got two left. Ah, this is what I was looking for. That's all you need for a bike light. It's one of these on the front, one on the back. These haven't got no batteries in, though. And these are Argos, because I've got an Argos brand there. The only place I've seen that sells challenge items is Argos, so I know this is Argos. I've got a rear one as well. They're on a pair of wheels that my friend gave me. But the batteries were dead, so I took them out before they leaked everywhere and ruined the lights. So I need two pairs of batteries, and I've only got one pair left. But I don't really need these just yet, so it's getting lighter at night, so I don't really need them. I'll save that until autumn, when the nights start getting dark again. When the nights start getting dark, of course the fucking nights get dark. When the nights start pulling in and the days get shorter. Oh, and I can't remember if I told you, but my £2.50 telephones work. Yeah, I did tell you, didn't I? Told you in the other... Told you earlier in the video. Yeesh, why was that so hard? I was just looked down and I saw the CD. I was playing that, what was it, New Hits 98. It's only had the one CD in it, but who cares? And I was just playing away on my PC, happily. And I was just scrolling through Facebook happily, and all of a sudden my computer crashed. Exactly like it did last time when I tried to play a CD. So, if I knew how to roll back to Windows 7, I would have told Windows 10 to fuck it. Fuck off by now. Because that takes the piss. Can't even play a CD without this crashing. Used to. I don't know why it started doing that, but I used to be able to. It played several songs. It did. It got to think, track 8 before it crashed. Either 7 or 8. It was either Barbie Girl... No, I don't think it was... It might have been Barbie Girl that was playing, actually. Or was it Spice Up Your Life? It might have even been Spice Up Your Life. By the Spice Girls, actually. Track 10. Somewhere around there it crashed, anyway. Or it just said your computer has encountered a problem and will restart. I actually don't like that, because I'd like to choose to restart the computer myself. I actually have to say, I have not itched as much today. I've got... Oh, that's what I got Nemo to try them on. They make the cat food I feed them on, I think. Yeah. This was Mum's idea. Got them a box of biscuits. I think they're only like 39p for that. So, I'm actually going to put some of these in his dish and see if he'll eat them. I'm not going to put a lot in there just in case he doesn't. I'm going to actually smell them through the box. Should we go do that? Let's go do that. Careful, Nemo. Put you up here where I normally put you. Now that the lights come on. Better put my eggs in the fridge. I had eggs, beans, chips, and ham again. Don't know why, but I've just fancied ham and chips for the last couple of days. Right. How fudge do you open this? Oh. Has it got one? Yes, it has. Yay! Look at that. All that space at the top there, just so they can put that on there, that's all it's for. Why don't they just put one in the top? Oh well. Reasons best known to those that designed it. Let's see what he does. He's actually eating them. Nice to change their food up a bit. I should think it gets boring eating the same stuff day in, day out. I've got one completely failed up that end. That one will go off. But this one, when that's actually charged up and nice and bright, that is actually quite nice how it lights up there. It's a pity I couldn't find more that work like that one. You know, and just put one the other end. Yeah, that one will go off. Yeah. So, next time I get paid, I need to just think. Sorry, I've got an itchy back. Of what I need to get to finish project. What I need to get to finish the projects I have. I'd like to get some done and dusted. My electric bike just needs a charger. Can't find a keyboard for that Fujitsu. Suppose I should give my brother a bit of cash for the laptop. And the computer memory, unless I can muster up some cash between now and then. Pardon me. Yeah. I've got some space on eBay to put some items, but I don't know what to put on there. Shite. Run out of cash, so I can't get a can of WD-40 either. You probably will never realise or understand how glad I am to be put on that support group and be receiving that extra cash. Is going to be such a help. such a help. It means I won't have to worry about putting myself short anymore. Might happen when I have on the... I cannot talk tonight, can I? It may happen once a month, because at least once a month I've got to pay the phone bill and my service charge together, which is about 120 quid. I'm actually going to go into my eBay, my BT account, I should say, and see if they've taken off the unlimited anytime calls. Simply because I barely phone out on my phone, and it was costing me an extra £7 on my phone bill that I don't really need, so I've opted to remove it. But I don't know if BT have. I haven't had an email notification. So I'm going to have to check. I'm not going to do it tonight, but I will check it. Just seen a video that I've seen before that someone shared. I've got US cops watching how the Scottish police take down a man wielding a knife. And then they show them footage of an actual incident where they're trying to take down a man in London with a knife. And I think American cops are just, well, they do look quite surprised that we don't use heavy force. Well, most of our cops don't. You know, we can use tasers, pepper sprays and whatnot and bring them down. But we also use numbers. If there is a man, or if there is a report of a man in the street with a knife or some other weapon, they will respond in large numbers. And as they did with this video on here, they will basically surround them. Surround the perpetrator, and perhaps while one side distracts the man, the other side will surprise attack him and bundle him to the ground and get the knife off of him. But it works without having to use lethal force. Yeah. Sometimes I think American cops do go overboard a bit and do get a bit trigger happy. Probably not as much as the media portrays them as doing. I mean, I'm all, at least once a day I'm seeing a some sort of article about an American cop that shot and killed someone. Oops. An American cop doing something dumb, basically. But I don't think they are that bad. I could be wrong. I don't live in America, so never had to encounter an American cop. Encountered British cops more times than I'd have liked, but I don't mind telling you what for, you know. First time, it was my brother's idea, and well, I didn't think that would actually be an issue because the house had been empty well over a year. Well over a year. No activity there whatsoever, so, you know, you think... And the fact that it had a planning notice outside to be demolished, which actually, it wasn't long after me and my brother got prosecuted for this that the house was demolished. Yeah, basically theft, because we took items from the house, so... Mind you, we would not have been caught if my brother hadn't left fingerprints. Now that's what got us caught. Because his fingerprints, he was always like the black sheep out of the pair of us. He was the one that always did the drugs, did the alcohol, always got into trouble, etc. So his prints were on record, mine weren't, so... Yeah, so obviously they fingerprinted the place and found my brother's prints, and my address was his last known address, so that's how they basically found it. But, yeah, I got 80 hours community service, and I think my brother got 120, something like that. And the second time I got arrested was for handling stolen goods. But I didn't actually know. Because one of my little brother's friends, not the one I just said that gets into trouble, my youngest brother, just turned 18, got given a bike by someone he trusted. Stupidly trusted, but trusted. And his mum wanted it out of the garage, so I ended up with it. And, again, the police initially came round looking for my brother, because I was staying with my brother at the time, I was living with him. And they just noticed it in the garden. Not knowing to me, or my brother's friend, that the person he got the bike from had actually stolen the fucking thing. But, yeah, that was, obviously, they had to arrest me, they didn't have a choice. But they didn't handcuff me. I was just sat in the back of the police car, taken down the police station. I don't even think I was put in a police holding cell that time. I was just taken straight through, interviewed, gave my statement, and basically told I could go home. You know, or to, I think I had to answer bail, so to speak, on a set date. And no further action, or NFA as they call it for short, was taken. Because I genuinely did not know. If I actually knew, I wouldn't have taken it, believe me. Because it's not worth the hassle. Anyway, there's a couple of random stories. Now, when I've been on a lot of courses and things, people think I've never done anything wrong, you know, because I'm always well behaved on these courses. And, oh, he's always well behaved. He knuckles down and does what he's told, blah, blah, blah. No, do I, bollocks. That halo isn't actually up there, it's around my ankles. Wish I could have a body transplant sometimes. I was going to say a skin transplant, so I didn't have this bloody psoriasis and whatnot. But then I realised I've got diabetes, I'm probably lactose intolerant, you know, and I've got lots of other niggles, crap eyesight in this eye, a cat in the way. Did you enjoy your biscuits? Did you? What should we do now, Nemo? Should I get this video up onto YouTube? I've already done one on the Lego channel, so I suppose I should do this one. After I've had a piss, because I'm sort of sitting here crossing my legs. I'm thirsty as well for some reason. I'll get myself a drink, go take a pee. But first, I'll get this video up onto the PC so I can edit it. I don't know, I'm just being random with the camera movement. He never gives a kiss, he just gives a little sniff. Just be... Look how he sits here, look. With his paws on the table. Back leg's on my leg. paws were on the table. That's how he was sitting. Dopey ass. But you're my dopey ass, aren't you? Hmm? Oh, your eyelashes tickled me. And I'm hoping that bloody skin tag under my eye will drop off. It's close. I've been twiddling it. It wouldn't bother me so much if it just wasn't, like I said, so much in my line of sight. Anyway, I'm about to run the battery out on this, so I'm going to shut the camera down. I'm not sure what I'm going to be doing tomorrow, not yet. I've got a choice. I can bring that rally back up and change the chain on that, because it's not very good. I know I've just wasted some oil on it, but yeah, shit happens. I've got plenty more oil where that came from. Or I could do the kids' bike, so I can actually sell something, hopefully. No? Alright then, sod you. See, I don't get kisses on him. If he was a dog, I'd have got kisses. I don't get kisses from him, he's a miserable bugger. Right. So, oh, and if Mum remembers, I should have some Lego coming. She owed me some cash, and I was going to buy some Lego off of my usual guy, and I couldn't, obviously, because of money issues, you know. Having a loan to Mum and having to pay bills, blah, 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 and never left me with a lot. So, and Mum, bless her, bought the Lego for me, so she should be dropping it off tomorrow, if she remembers. If not, I'll have to get it Sunday when I go over, it's not a problem. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching, and I will talk to you all tomorrow. Bye!